So you have really basically a scandal in the world with so many children dying, 6.5 million children dying under the age of 5. On the other hand, as the world develops, you have a situation where you have older people, people of who are above 50, 60, having an epidemic of diabetes, of cancer, of cardiovascular disease, and eventually neurodegenerative disease. This is something that's sort of hitting India right now, but we're still a relatively young country. We are not really seeing what this actually means for the long term. But if you go to, let's say, a country like the US or Europe, where people are aging, and you have chairmen of various committees who are 70 and 80 years old, all of a sudden they realize that funding neurodegenerative disease is important, as long as they don't forget it, right? They realize it's important. So you have a situation where healthcare becomes of primary importance from a moral, ethical point of view, where you have so many infants whose lives are being cut short in countries like India. On the other hand, you have an epidemic in the older population, which are being lost, robbed of their productivity. So healthcare for me spans these two spectrums, the communicable diseases, which are the diseases of the young, and the older and the non-communicable diseases. So healthcare really has to involve prevention, treatment, diagnostics, etc., etc., right? There are many, many factors in it that we have to take into account. And because it's such a complex field, nobody can do it alone. I think it's important to understand that this has to be done in the form of partnerships, right? Both from a country security point of view, it has to be done within countries, but it also requires people to collaborate between countries in trying to get this to happen, because there are so many different aspects to it. There is basic science, our understanding of biology, our understanding of chemistry, there's basic engineering, trying to have the right technology to build factories, to build devices, to build diagnostics. You need to really try and span the entire gamut of science and engineering to be able to do this. But then let's not forget, very importantly, creating the ecosystem that connects all these people together. You cannot have a situation where scientists work by themselves, clinicians work by themselves, engineers work by themselves. People have to work with each other. And then the end of this game is about the investment. Who will invest in this? Who will invest in this? That's one part of the money. The second part of the money is, who will pay for these services? Who will buy these products? So you have a unique aspect of it. So that, you know, we have very aptly today a very senior government official, Dr. Bangar Rajam, who will try and talk through what the government's perspective on this is, because it's the government is a key enabler and a key stakeholder in all this that we're talking about. So apart from the facilities, you also need manpower. You need skilled manpower. You don't need people with degrees, but you need people who can think, about how we solve our problems. And I think it's a very key element of it. I'd like to add a couple of more comments before getting on to the session for today. We have in the world a couple of ends of the spectrum. I think India is on one end of the spectrum. We spend 1% or less of our GDP on healthcare in terms of public funding. On the other end of the spectrum, you have the US, which is about 18 to 20% of spending. Both of these models do not work. Despite tremendous progress that's been made, both these models do not work. And the reason they do not work, and I was thinking this morning about the Mangalyaan mission. We talked about we can do something at 1/10 the cost. But having 1% of GDP and 20% of GDP is really 1/100th. Right? So there's a big gap. We're not at 1/10, we're at 1/100th in a country like India. So we have to be careful. In particular, also noting the fact that out-of-pocket expense is more than 85% in India, it results in people sliding back into poverty. So there is well understood, I think, political consensus in terms of the fact that healthcare is important, but how do we enable that is the key element. And for me, it is really a combination of private and public investments, cooperation, that makes this happen. It cannot happen almost in any other way, given the way we are structured as a society.